People like me are coming, Judge Johnston.
One of them is up a year in jail and a $6,250 fine.
One guy just spent a year in jail and a $652 fine. So he's throwing out a year in jail threat to his imagination when the state is offering 8 hours of community service. And what was his actual crime? Not wanting to get molested at an airport. It is dangerous. Dangerous to be an American in 2016. And to challenge the state with just, where's your evidence of jurisdiction? The military has it with the UCMJ. Ambassadors have it with diplomatic immunity. There's paperwork that exists that signifies and satisfies the element of jurisdiction. By definition, element means if you don't have it, you have nothing. You have no completed puzzle if you miss one puzzle piece. An element of jurisdiction is a puzzle piece, and you know it. And you force this through violence. I'm going to force this shit and nobody's going to challenge me. Oh, you're getting challenged. Federal court.
So, and that's what I don't count.
And that's just, we both know that's just one of many options.
The other count, I believe, is 3 days and $1,250. So, those are the risks that are on the table.
Those are the risks that are on the table. You need to be aware. Do you understand? So you've got until the end of today to contact and get this plea. You know what happened? You know what happened? Our hero said, "F*** your plea." And he didn't go sign it. And he didn't take it. And he's still fighting. And he's coming at you again. And the next series I do on this case is going to be his personal story from his own mouth. So that story is coming. And it's a good one. Let me give you a highlight reel. The judge, the next time our hero challenged jurisdiction, had coordinated this to happen. He put the whole hearing on pause, and in walks nine, not 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, or 8, but 9 armed police. They enter the courtroom and line up against the wall in nothing more than an intimidating-looking firing squad. To try and scare our hero to quit challenging jurisdiction. Why? Because it's true. It's the linchpin. You pull this cornerstone, the whole thing falls down, and they know it. Well, it's getting out on YouTube, and there's nothing you can do about it.
And keep in mind, the last few possibly entertain extending it, and we could address it a later date. Thank you very much.
He just kicked your ass, and do you know how? By not falling victim, not giving into anger, having the discipline to remain calm, cool, collected, keep firing back when he could, and not be trolled into jail, despite your very best efforts. You people, the state, have been so abusive. Now the educated classes are getting tangled in. And they don't fall to your typical tricks and games because they're bright enough and disciplined enough to see the big picture. They know exactly what's going on here. This is politics. This is not a courtroom, and it's certainly not a public one. And he can't even record to remember everything was said. He has to go off of memory and off of your edited audio video that costs money and will take a couple months to get. After the trial, these impositions cause harm that are irreparable. And if they're not addressed immediately, permanent damage is done that can't be undone. Federal lawsuit. And your kids are gonna find this out. Your family's gonna find this out.
YouTube, and I
objection.
I mean, there's no basis for an objection right now to serve, so let him talk.
As I said, Your Honor, I, as an officer of the court, I feel this is my duty to let people know that potentially the supplemental rules of the UTCR would be violated such, and I believe that either or associated fees were recording the hearings in place of them on YouTube, and I brought that to the court's attention just so the court could be aware of that and do with that information what it will, whether it was permit that or disallow it. But that's the same information at this time that I'm conveying to the court.
Thank you very much. I understand that as an individual who came to court today with the intent of recording these proceedings, you are in fact recording these proceedings, you are in contempt, and I will hold you in contempt. And it's likely you will end up going to jail today. Is there anyone who misunderstands that? Sir, are you recording this?
No, Your Honor, I'm the one that requested the recording. My phone's off, and I don't have the camera on me.
Thank you.
I think making allegations is way out.
Just sit down, please, sir. You're not a part of any of what's going on today, sir.
All right. And Judge, the court need further information about the reason that the state has that ability and want to share that information.
Sure, please do.
There's a YouTube channel under Mr. name, and it posts the arraignment and other such issues, and in the comments read that same person under the username is discussing proceedings as they've been developing ongoing. Therefore, I thought as an officer of the court, I should inform the court of that information regarding potential violations of the SOR and the PCR.
All right, Mr. Escrow.
May I object to that?
No, you may not. You can answer the allegation. Did you record these proceedings?
I have not recorded these
proceedings. Did you? Okay, the previous proceedings. That's good. The first things have you. Any proceedings in this court of any kind?
I have not recorded proceedings, and I object to the accusation. Last week, he made the accusation that I had.
I don't care whether you say they're false. Just say they're not true. Make an assertion. Stand by your words.
Well, what I'm wondering is, No, I have not made any recordings.
Now, I'm not asking that. Did you post it?
Did you post
the proceeding? Did you post a recording of any proceedings of this court?
I have not posted proceedings.
Okay. I'm not asking that. Did you post any proceedings of this court?
No.
All right. We have that on the record. If it subsequently turns out that they might find out that, in fact, you did, then perhaps the tenor of this case will get a little hotter for you, sir. What are we doing here today? We're here on community court, is that correct?
Correct, Your Honor. And Judge Gaston's last order reflects that Mr. was to make an election regarding community court or to schedule the case for trial.
All right, what would you like to do, Mr.?
Well, I'm attempting to...
I know what you're attempting to do. I'm asking you a question. What do you want to do? You're not going to write rush out of this court.
May I speak without you?
You have an option. And I'm giving it to you. How do you wish to proceed? It's do you want a trial or do you want to resolve this today in community court?
It's my goal to resolve this today.
All right. So, you like to participate in the community court program, is that correct? Those are your only options.
Right now?
That's your only option right now.
Right now, you keep interrupting me and I'm not sure what I want to say.
I'm giving you your options, sir. I'm trying to confine you to the proceedings of this court. That's it.
Objection. I have...
You don't get to object against me, sir. You get to listen to me or you get to respond. That's all. How do you proceed, sir?
Am I being asked if I can enter a plea right now, or I'm not sure what you're asking?
Here you are. You can participate in any community service program, sir. In which case,
Yes, Your Honor, the state has actually given the offer at this point. I handed it to Mr. in court at the last appearance. If the court would like to know the details of that offer, I'm really happy to elaborate. If you would, please. The offer was to plead one count, the hours of community service for dismissal, failure would be default for the amount of judge.
All right. You have option. And it's customary in these matters to negotiate, as the state has offered me, extended an offer to you. I can't tell you whether it's a good offer, but it is the only offer on the table. You can say, I don't wish to accept that offer, and we'll set this matter for trial. Or you can say, I wish to accept the offer, in which case you have to enter a plea of guilty. And it appears as though if you perform 8 hours of community service, this matter would be dismissed. That means no criminal charges, no other sanctions, nothing else would occur. But if you don't, it would be a $435 fine. Those are the options you have, sir.
And it would be a reduction to violation.
And a reduction to violation, which is a big plus. It really is. So, because you are pro se, you decided to proceed on your own, you're stuck with this decision.
May I make an informed plea?
How much more information do you want?
There are things which concern me about the cause nature of the hearing that I'm still...
We're not going to go into that. We're not going to go into that collateral nonsense. You can bring those up at a later date. This is not the forum, sir. So, you can... Those are your options, sir. How do you wish to proceed? Put on your big white pants, Tom.
What I'm asking is, I haven't even been arraigned. I'm still trying to understand the cause and nature of these proceedings.
My understanding is that he was in fact arraigned by Ms. Coletta downtown. These issues were brought up in last year. Judge Gaston informed me that the cause and nature of these proceedings is that he's charged with the crimes of the county of Multnomah, state of Oregon. And Judge Gaston made an explicit finding on the record that the court had jurisdiction over this action.
Thank you. So you have that. And so you're proceeding this started. How do you wish to proceed?
It's my intention.
I don't care about your intention other than you've got to tell me what you want to do. You've got to answer my questions. I'm not going to go into your nonsense.
I'm attempting to answer your questions, and I believe that you are interrupting me at this point before I can ever make my intentions clear. So I feel like you are
Want to tell me. Here are the options. Do you wish to proceed in community court, or do you want to go to trial?
I wish to make an informed plea.
Okay, what does that mean?
I wish to, it's my intention to make an informed plea of guilty, but I have not yet been informed as to the cause of the jury proceedings.
Okay, you have been. We'll pass that. And
you
don't get to object to me. You can object to other individuals, other proceedings. You don't get to object to me. No. You can answer my question. You're on thin ice. Do you want to spend some more time in jail? Because I'm more than happy to do that. And it isn't going to be one day. It's going to be a lot more days. If you've got enough of the time on your hands, you can do that. But you horsed around and screwed around, and enough is enough. So, how do you wish to proceed? I'm giving you your options.
Then, I will make a decision under duress.
Then go ahead. What is your decision?
I'll enter an uninformed plea of not guilty.
All right, then we'll set this matter for trial, and we'll go from there.
Okay.
Thank you very much.